Today I'm making a jerky video showing how to make the simplest of jerky. To begin with, I'm going to plan ahead. I know that this is going to be a greasy operation, so there's two things I'm going to do to make cleanup a little bit easier. First one is to cut wax paper squares, and any wax paper will do. And I have a little paper cutting device that'll help me with this. And I have it marked so that I know what the approximately correct size is for the squares on my jerky maker. And so I'm going to just cut several of these as an example. So I just cut five of them lengthwise, and that would be enough for one tray. Then I'm going to put these five strips together and cut them in the opposite direction to make squares. So what I end up with is a stack of wax paper squares, and each one's about the size of a piece of jerky that I'm going to put onto the tray. And I have a little container here where I keep them pre-made, so that when I have spare time, I can fill up this container and have them ready. Second step is, again, I know it's going to be greasy, so I'm going to line the bottom of the tray with these ordinary grease towels that you can get at any hardware store for absorbing grease. And I'm going to take two of them and cut them in half. Then I'm going to take the bottom of the jerky maker tray and tape these onto it so that they overlap a little bit and stay in place as the air is circulating through the jerky maker. And I'm going to apply just ordinary scotch tape to the corners to hold them down. And so next I'm going to put the first tray on, first of five of these trays, and just set that down here in my sink so it'll be ready to put on the jerky after I cut it. And on each one of these trays, I'm going to place my freshly cut wax paper squares. Time for another tray, and in case you're wondering, this does hinder the circulation of the air a little bit, but I'm only going to leave them on for about the first 6 to 12 hours. Then I'm going to take them off so that I get great circulation. And the secondary purpose of these, first is to catch grease, and the second is to give the meat a little bit of time to harden so that it'll be easier to toss over and it won't be sticking to the grills, the spokes of these trays when I want to flip it over. Of course, if I were in business making tons of this each week, I probably wouldn't bother with this, and I'd have a high-powered dishwasher that could take care of all the cleanup. But I don't have a dishwasher, so that's why I like to do as much as I can to make the cleanup easy. Because I only do this about once a month, then I have enough jerky to last me for another month. Okay? So now I'm going to cut the bacon, slice it. One that I happened to get today is from Trader Joe's. It is uncured turkey bacon. It's just a little bit closer, so you can see a typical package. And there's like about four different kinds of bacon that are great. The regular belly bacon is terrible because it's very difficult to cut and very tough to chew. So what I like is this turkey bacon and also pork shoulder bacon, because they're already it's already chopped and formed. Most of the jerky that I make is marinated and on ground meat, like ground turkey, ground beef. And so this is already chopped. The ingredients are minimal. They're great natural ingredients, uncooked. And I'll show samples of the other kind. This is my top kind that I like. The other great thing about turkey bacon, or any of the bacon, is that it's already sliced very thin, which makes it ideal for jerky, because it helps the air circulate past it and dry it out much faster. So this one I know to make squares, I only have to cut it three times, one right down the middle, and again, very easy to slice this, very difficult to slice belly bacon because of the tendons, and I'm going to slice it now one more time on this end to make squares, and on this end. So that's all the slicing that I have to do on this particular package. I've got, each package is about 8 ounces, so I've got four packages to make 2 pounds, and now it's just a matter of spreading this out. And as I'm finished with each package, I'm going to put them in plastic garbage bags for easy disposal. And so I just went into my bathroom to wash my hands before I open up this last set of wax paper squares so that my hands would be relatively clean. Now the other trick that I'm going to do here as I get near the end, I could put on another tray, I do have a 6-1, but what I'm going to do is instead just double up some of these pieces, and then after the first during the first rotation, I'll separate them. So I'm just going to, you can see I doubled up these pieces, now I'm going to lay some flat, just so it all gets used up. That's it. So you can't see it, but my fan, the top part of this jerky maker, is in my little laundry room here, and I'm going to carry this over to it next. And so there it is on top of my washer and dryer, and I'm now going to put the lid on it. Like that. And this is made by Nesco, American Harvest Food Dehydrator and Jerky Maker. And it used to have a temperature dial on it. However, I do not want any heat applied to my jerky to get the best jerky possible with the highest protein concentrated in it. And so now I'm just going to turn it on, and it'll be there for, like I said, right now it happens to be about noontime on a Saturday. So before I go to bed tonight, I'm going to flip everything over once, remove all the wax papers, and that's what we'll see next.
Okay. So now about 8 hours have elapsed since I began drawing this turkey and turkey bacon jerky. You can kind of see how they look now. Most of the water has gone, so they're dried at a touch, but obviously they're not fully dry yet. It's probably going to take a couple days to fully dry them. And now what I'm going to do is just take off the wax paper squares that I used to keep it clean and easy for to keep it easy to clean. And make it so that a benefit of this paper is that while the bacon is still soft, it won't get stuck on the tray, making it difficult to pull off. And because when I first began making jerky, that was always a problem. You start to drying it and wanted to turn it over, and I had a hard time doing that just because it would stick and then break apart and crumble and stuff like that. So this is my own little technique that I developed to prevent that from happening, and it's worked out really well. And at the same time that I'm taking these off, I'm flipping over most of these. I think I lost track, but normally what I do is when I take it off, it'll still be a little bit moist between the jerky and the paper, wax paper, so it's going to get dry a lot quicker now that the paper is gone and one side of it is relatively dry. And also these pieces that were doubled up, I'm now separating them. So it's still a little bit crowded here, but what's going to happen is that as it dries more, it's going to shrink. And no matter what size you start out with, it'll always end up much smaller. And the other thing I'm going to do now, as I take off each tray, I'm going to eventually rotate them when I put them back so that they'll be at different heights within the whatever you want to call this jerky maker thingy, for lack of a better technical term. So we'll see how fast I can do this now. After a while, you develop a technique and you can improve your speed, kind of like skyscraper staircase racing. So here we go. I'm going to shift into overdrive now. And I'm going to slow down now just to say that earlier today I was doing some research onto four other brands of bacon that I use for jerky that are awesome, and I'm going to post or include photos and descriptions of those. And the price for this is really reasonable. This is about $7 a pound at Trader Joe's, and they're all kind of comparable. The other ones you'll see are a little bit more expensive. And they have slightly different ingredients. One of them is my favorite because it tastes so much like buttered popcorn. But all of them are excellent and super delicious, and it's all I can do to restrain myself from just eating all of this right now. But I want to wait till it's thoroughly dry so that the protein that forms is much healthier and concentrated. And the other thing that I do is throughout the course of the 2 days that I dry this is I rotate the trays from top to bottom. So this tray that's currently on the bottom, I'm going to restack all the trays except the last one, and then the one that was on top is going to be the new bottom. And so I'll rotate them a total of 5 times. And the other thing I do is I rotate them 90 degrees, and just to help because the fan that circulates isn't perfectly even. And so there we go. Ready for another, it's over. Going to be overnight now. So when I wake up in the morning, I'll do the same thing. I'll flip the pieces over, rotate the trays, and each morning and evening, so every 12 hours or so, I'll go through all four or all five trays. So we'll have an opportunity to be in each of the five positions. Okay, so 2 days have elapsed, and I've cycled through all the different levels of trays so that this one that's on the top now was originally on the bottom. And you can kind of see here as an example how much the bacon jerky has shrunk as it's converted from watery bacon to jerky bacon. And I'll hold up one little piece. By the way, the one that had overlapped, because this used to be the top tray, and now you can see it has a lot more space than before. So that's sort of what I meant. They shrink in size by about a half. And another way you can tell when it's dried enough, because that's another common question, is that it's so dry that it just moves on the tray like this very easily. And especially another second way you can tell is that when you crack it, let me just see if I can get this close up. Right about there. You can see it just cracks and snaps. It doesn't tear, and just a very clean break. Again, you see that? So I'm going to have to eat this right now. Yummy. Now you have to wait for me to chew this because you can't really chew jerky. You gotta suck in your mouth and let your saliva water it down so that it becomes easier to swallow. Oh, that's so delicious. Because the other great thing about jerky is it preserves the flavor. Whenever you cook something, the more you heat it, obviously it loses flavor. And you know that by experience, because if you burn your food, burn a steak, or cook it so long that it gets hard, it loses all of its flavor. But when you just dry it at room temperature, it has so much more flavor and you really notice the difference. So now what I'm going to do is package it up in these Ziploc freezer bags, nice and thick, and like that with a double seal, and just drop in each piece. This is a little bit time consuming, but since I'm a skyscraper staircase racer, watch and see how fast I can go. So there you have it. This is 2 pounds of raw, uncooked meat, and you can see it fits into this little bag. I haven't weighed it, but I'm guessing it's less than a pound, and it's extremely delicious, very healthy, great weight, great source of protein.